Welcome you all. I am Professor Anurag Karande, going to explain you about the gyroscopic effect on aeroplane. But before that, we must know what is gyroscopic effect and why it is developed. So, to understand the gyroscopic effect, let us consider one disc rotating in a plane. This we consider as a plane, and one disc is rotating inside the plane. This is the disc. Here it is called as an axis of spin. We are providing some direction to the disc. Now, while rotation, we will provide some angular velocity. While rotation, I am providing some angular velocity to the disc. Here we will get the new axis of spin. Now, as far as gyroscopic effect concerned, the axis of spin, this is the axis of spin, is called as axis of precision. So, we will call it as a axis of precision. And new axis, this is the new axis. This new axis is called as an angular velocity of precision. Called as angular velocity of precession. After this, we need to understand the concept of gyroscopic couple. So, after getting angular velocity of precision, the disc experiencing some momentum. What I said? The axis of precision which we are providing at the first, and then we are giving some angular velocity to this disc. When we are giving some angular velocity, at that time this disc is experience some momentum, and due to that momentum, while turning the disc in any of the direction, gyroscopic couple is induced in that. And here we are having two gyroscopic couples, one is active and another is reactive. And because of reactive gyroscopic couple, the disc may get their position, may get change that position. So, when we are providing some angular velocity to the disc, at that time, the gyroscopic couple is induced in that. So, what is that gyroscopic couple? I will tell you. First of all, from this figure, we understand the actual moment of rotation of the disc. Now, from this figure, we will understand the parts of aeroplane. This is the front end, which we are calling as a nose, and this rear part is called as a tail. The front part is also having the position of propeller. This is the position of propeller. Now let's discuss some condition of aeroplane. Condition number one is, let us consider a condition number one. Condition number one of the aeroplane takes a right turn. Aeroplane takes right turn. From the looking from the rear end, and propeller rotates in anticlockwise direction. Looking from rear end, and propeller rotates in counterclockwise direction. Okay, so for to understand this condition, this is the condition number one. Okay, I'm again reading this. Aeroplane takes a right turn. looking from the rear end, means we are looking at this from this end, and the propeller rotates in counterclockwise direction. So now to understand the condition, we need to use our right hand thumb rule for finding the exact position of aeroplane after taking the right turn. Here I am using my right hand to understand this condition number 1. What is the condition number 1? The aeroplane takes right turn and looking from the rear end, propeller rotates in counterclockwise. Now in right hand thumb rule, this thumb indicates the axis of rotation and this curl finger shows the rotation of the propeller. So when we are looking from the rear end, let us consider the aeroplane. This is the aeroplane. We are looking from the rear end and the propeller rotates in anti-clockwise direction, means the curl finger are like this and the thumb is like this. So from this we can understand what actually this condition gives us. The thumb shows, I'm again telling you, the thumb shows the axis of spin and the curl finger shows the rotation of the propeller. Okay, now the aeroplane takes a right turn, means aeroplane is taking a right turn, means this is the right turn. Okay, now this is the curl finger. Okay, this position indicates the actual active gyroscopic couple, the effect of gyroscopic couple like this. This is the active gyroscopic couple and opposite to that, this is the reactive gyroscopic couple. Okay, so I am again telling you, this is the right hand thumb rule we are using for understanding the gyroscopic couple. Here is the condition number 1. Aeroplane takes a right turn looking from the rear end and propeller rotates in counterclockwise direction. Okay, let us consider this is our aeroplane. This is the front end, this is the rear end, and we are looking from the rear end. Okay, now to understand the effect of gyroscopic couple, we are looking from the rear end and we are considering this right hand thumb rule to understand this condition. So now here we are giving the aeroplane to take a right turn. Okay, aeroplane is shifting towards right and this curl finger shows the active gyroscopic couple, and opposite to this one we are giving this reactive gyroscopic couple, and reactive gyroscopic couple shows the fingers are coming upward from downward, upward from downward. So like this our plane is shifted from front end, means our plane is shifted from front end. That's why in this condition the nose will rises and the tail goes down. So this is the actual condition of aeroplane when we are considering a case number 1. Now after condition number 1, we are having many conditions like aeroplane takes a left turn looking from the rear end and propeller rotates in counterclockwise direction opposite to this condition. Similarly, we are also taking aeroplane towards the left and looking from the rear end and propeller rotates in counterclockwise. So try to find the similar position of the plane for various condition, and I am suggesting you getting some more details, log in to jitmeepathshala.gnomio.com. That is your Moodle ID. Go to your Moodle ID and check out the notes of the gyroscope. In the next class, I will tell you the concept of gyroscopic effect on naval ship. Thank you.